I'm sure it was nerve-wracking and you did feel that pressure, but I think for a lot of people, they actually really enjoy the fact that this is your first time. This is your first go at this.
Thank you. Yeah, no, I legitimately didn't know what to expect. Like that first rose ceremony, like I literally couldn't speak. Like I couldn't get words out because I was so nervous and I felt horrible sending great women home that I didn't have a chance to speak to. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. It's like I felt so bad and that was real. And everything I felt throughout that whole process was real because I didn't know how the dynamics of a group date work or how an after party or a cocktail hour worked. Like things were happening in real time and I'm just dealing with them like some random dude off the street, like, yo, go in there and do this. And like, that's how I was like kind of handling every situation. So I felt like I could relate to the women from a standpoint of like, look, we're going through this together. Like I don't know what to expect. Like but what I can do is be my authentic self and be vulnerable with you so that opens up and sets the stage and the floor for you to be open and vulnerable. Because if we're here, we might as well go for it. You know what I mean? Like, I'm not going to waste your time. I'm going to meet you where you're at. And that's what I tried to do.
Mm-hmm. I appreciate that. You know, be unapologetically yourself. Like Becca and I said, and Becca just told you, it was endearing that you were nervous. You could tell, but it was like, oh, he's not out here trying to be the next a bachelor he saw before.